Hello everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Daiva V for the MSX. Okay, in the previous part we captured our first planet, so we're going to attempt to repeat our lucky start by capturing this one as well. Again, the bomb, I think I'll put it... You know what, I vaguely... No, actually I have no idea which is the most difficult one. I'll just put it in the third area again, because that's always the one... the last one you have to do, so it's the easiest to avoid, probably. To avoid that one, probably. We'll set the time units, or the energy unit, for 180 again. Okay, well, these guys are pretty easy, so this first area shouldn't be too hard. And they have two different movement patterns, as you can see. One of them swoops down, and the other ones just move up and down. Up and down ones are really easy. The swooping one can be a little bit dangerous, but if you pay attention, they won't get you. Especially because they go down with only a single hit. These guys are really pushovers. Oops. Well, last one. Move back a bit. Ooh, these guys. These are a little more tricky. Because they take a couple shots to kill, and they move out of the screen fairly quickly, so you have to be quick to kill them. Thankfully, the defense rating of this planet is fairly low, so we don't have to kill that many. But they are far from ideal. Not like the little guys we're fighting at the start. I think we should be getting close to killing them now, right? Come on. Come on, out already. Just need a couple more. Keep shooting me in the back. There we go, out. Now we can move on to the next area. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, some of the enemies have little turrets, so you have to watch those when you move on to the next area. Oh, there we go. Okay, yeah, these are a little bit more tricky, because they're very fast, but still not the worst of the worst. They only take two shots and they're small. Oops. And also, the easier they die, so the less shots they take, the less of your energy they take if you collide with them, so it's not as terrible as with the other guys if you do run into them. Those large ones, if you hit them, they can really mess you over. Even just with a single hit, they can do pretty significant damage to you. I'm losing a lot of health, but it's okay, we've already cleared two areas. So hopefully I'll be able to clear this one as well. And then either let the bomb take care of the third one, or if they're not too hard to kill, maybe we'll be able to finish that one as well. I'm not doing very well. I used to be really good at this game, but it's been a couple of years. Oops. There's one of those turret guys. You really don't want to lose any health to these turrets, because it's embarrassing. Because they are so easy to avoid. Okay, final part. Let's see what we have here. Okay, well, these aren't too hard either. I mean, they're not as easy as some of the other ones, but... there are definitely worse enemies out there, so we're gonna have a try. If I run too low on energy, I might just leave them. I'm actually running low on time as well, so I might not be able to finish these, but that's okay. Although, you know what, if the timer does hit zero, you don't want to be in the area when the bomb goes off. So, I have only a few seconds left. I think I'll leave these guys. If I can't, just kill them in the last couple of seconds, which is still kind of possible. No, it's not. Ah! Okay, let's just let the timer run out. And hope the bomb will be enough to kill them all. And again, I forgot to set a timer, so I'm not really sure how long this has been, but whatever. Probably about 200 seconds. Yep, I think we got it. There we go. So now we have 5 planets to their 5, but at least we equalized. Of course, we didn't really equalize because their planets are much better than mine, but you know, whatever. You have to start somewhere. We might even be able to capture this one if we could get rid of his fleet flying around it. And it's fleet number 1, so this is his big fleet, basically. Let's see how hard this one would be to capture. Ooh, that looks like a good one. Low defense, high environment, high resources. Not too much technology, but we can fix that. So again, we'll create a new fleet. We'll create it here. Assign a missile ship. And we will move Akusho up to here. Hopefully put a little bit of pressure on his ships. And we'll move Vishnu down here so we can try and attack that planet next turn. Now I'm a little bit torn. Should I try and attack his fleet with mine? Because mine currently is a lot stronger than his, because I focused all my forces in this one fleet. Or should I just grab another planet? You know what? I think I'll go for another planet battle. I'll just quick save the state for now, just make sure we can go back if I mess it up. but we'll try and capture Shakuti. Let's see if this will work. So we're back at planet number 3. Again, I have no idea what kind of enemies we're facing here, so I'm just going to drop the bomb over here and put the energy unit in the standard place and time. Okay, looks like we're starting with relatively easy enemies, although I'm already getting hit, so that's not a good sign. Easy enemies are kicking your ass, that means you're not a very good player. Now, I think after this planet, whether I conquer it or not, I'll try and play a little bit off-screen and get some more resources and maybe some more planets captured so I can showcase a little bit more of the advanced game. Just, I feel like this is getting a little bit repetitive. Actually, you know what? No, you know what? First thing I'll do is I'll try and showcase one of the fleet battles because those are quite cool. Oh, God, I hate these guys. I remember these. They kind of look like fleas and they act like fleas, and that makes them really annoying and hard to hit. They have a very annoying movement pattern. So you are very likely to miss them even if you shoot at them for like 10 years. Go away. I think of all the small enemies, these are some of the most annoying ones. Not the hardest, but definitely very annoying. Take them out as quickly as possible. Of course, that's always a good idea, but you know. It's a little bit obvious, maybe. I think they take 2 or 3 hits as well, which is pretty bad for one of those small guys. I don't think we're gonna make this one. I'm already losing way too much energy. But at least I know what we're facing now. Oops, I forgot about the goddamn turrets. How embarrassing. Yeah, there's no chance we've conquered this one. Only clearing 2 areas and losing your fleet is pretty much guaranteed that this conqueror will fail. Yep, it failed. Shippai shimashita. Teikuku no... No, I have no idea what that says either. Pretty sure it's something about his fleet, but I don't know. My Japanese, unfortunately. Oh, now I understand. It's occasionally planets will rebel, especially if you put up their tax rates too high. And I don't know if you noticed in the previous part, he set his tax rates to 70% or something. Yeah, it's still there. And the planet revolted and went back to neutral, so that's pretty good for me. Okay, I'm gonna try and move my fleet up to here. And hopefully he won't move away. And he didn't, so I get to showcase fleet battle real quick. I'm hoping I still have enough time in this part, but if not, I'll just have to cut it up into two parts. So here we go, fleet battle. Time to show you how it's done. So fleet battles are the tactical aspect of the game. First, what you have to do is you position your fleet. After you've done that, the enemy gets a chance to position his fleet, they exchange fire, and well, let me just show you because it's a little bit tricky to explain. Actually, I remember now why missile ships are useful in some occasions. First, let me show you the ships. These are the battleships, these are cruisers, these are missile ships, and these are laser ships. Now, the advantage to lasers over missiles is that they can fire through asteroids. Missiles get stopped in asteroids fields. The downside of lasers is that they don't always hit. A missile is pretty much guaranteed damage to the other side. The way it works is you place your ships up to this dividing line. So the central line is kind of the limit as to where you or the enemy can place their ships. And the closer you are to the center, the earlier your ship will fire. So if I place my ship here, it'll fire sooner than if I place it here. And the same goes for him. His ships in the central line fire first, then the second line, and the third line, and so on. Unfortunately, the enemy always has the initiative, so that means he always gets the fire first, then my first line gets the fire, then his second line gets the fire, then my second line gets the fire, and so on. So, what I like to do is I like to put a few ships up front just to soak up some damage. Few little ones that I can afford to miss. Put my big ships behind it so they can have a good chance of getting some shots off as well. And then finally, yeah, let's just place one or two of these guys over here because, see, over here these little guys aren't going to instantly kill my battleships. The advantage I have is that I can move my ships anywhere, and I believe the AI only moves their ships like one or two squares away from their starting position. It's been a while, so I don't know if this is really optimal, but I'm gonna just give it a try. Well, at least I killed a bunch of his stuff without taking any damage in the first round. That's always good. The downside is that his battleship is still alive. But we'll try and fix that. Did he take any damage? He did take a little bit of damage. Not too much. He didn't, so... Let's see if we can... take out as much of his stuff as we can. As you can see, we have battle turn 1 out of 2 listed above. You get 3 segments to each turn, and at the end of each turn, you can try to either retreat or continue. Okay, he stayed in position, that's kind of good for me, I think. Ooh, damn, I don't know, I'm gonna lose my battleship or anything. Oh no! Lucky, I might even take out his. Oh no, I don't. That's a shame. Mine's pretty badly damaged, but his is even more, I think, yeah. So close to killing his. I'm not sure why my missile ships didn't fire. Maybe they have to be in the front line, I don't really remember. Let's try that again. He's probably gonna run away after this round. Because he only has one battleship left. Yeah, he ran away. Oh well, that's okay. We killed everything except one battleship, that's a win in my book. Okay, I think I'll cut off the video here, because I think we're probably coming up to 15 minutes already. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next part.